Were you not a little hesitant with the whole fact that this is the most politically controversial film you're doing?
Yep. I was not just nervous, I was scared. I was scared because unfortunately this tragedy has a political connotation attached.
Exactly.
But then somebody has to tell these stories. And to be honest, I consider myself very fortunate that people want me or probably associate, you know, strong content or, for the lack of a better word, different content in cinema with me.
Do you guys ever hesitate? You know, at the end of the day, you're humans and you've been giving interviews, especially for a controversial subject like this, day in and day out.
Yep.
So do you feel it's unfair that actors are told that if you're doing a film like Sabarmati Report, you also have to be very politically correct and politically moral? You cannot deflect from that. Do you feel it's unfair?
It is. I mean, not just with a particular film. I think with everything that we do, and I think I can speak for the entire community, there are so many eyes on us. There is very little benefit of doubt given to us.
Absolutely.
Considering the fact that we are humans ourselves.
Exactly.
And you can never go wrong. And these days, the actors also have to get their politics right, their GK right, their current affairs right, everything right besides acting. So it's so much of pressure, you know. But that is how it is, and it's unfair.
Hey guys, I'm Manjari Mukherjee, and you are watching me on Pop Diaries channel. They say find your truth, know your truth. And is both ko. It's the burden of truth that we all carry in some way or the other. But somehow we forget that in puri zindagi mein, we don't try to
really, really go deeper and know what exactly happened, when it happened, and how it happened. And such is the case with Sabarmati Report. And bringing the truth behind this whole incident, the darkest days in our history, is none other than Vikrant Masi and the team of today. On Pop Diaries.
Wow, that's amazing.
Thank you so much, Manjari.
Thank you. Firstly, I have to tell you that
I'm a fan of both. You know it, but for her, it's the first time that I'm meeting her. So I need to tell you, I'm a big fan. Mm-hmm. Now, the question that I was really wanting to ask you, be it Maryada, be it Asur, be it Jawan, or be it now, where you're playing one of my most favorite characters, I feel, I haven't seen the film, but what I feel from the trailer is this boss lady who gets her things done. She's sassy, she's on her toes, and she keeps everyone else also on her toes. But you're also representing the whole body of system. And that's beautiful, the way how they represent one full body of system through one person. And I want to know, not why you chose the character, I'm glad you did, but why such strong characters? Don't you
become Masi and the people with me today? On Pop Diaries.
Wow, that's amazing.
Thank you so much.
You always do that.
Exactly why I want to play strong characters. I am a rebel without a cause. it's just something that I picked up to do. I have a problem with women repression. I have a problem, general problem. I don't know. I think I'll have to do some past life regression to understand why does this bother me so much. But I cannot stand for a woman's voice being stopped or paused or being subdued. And it happens so much because we are such nurturers and we will put everyone before us. And when I say this, I'm not even saying this for working women. I'm saying this for housewives. I'm saying it for our grandmothers. I'm saying it for there's such strong women. Women are always strong emotionally and mentally, but we're always suppressed and we always put others before us. So I just want to stand as that woman who says, no.
So that's it.
Someone said, I was reading this the arcade, some philosopher, Jogandaya, I don't know the name, he said that
women are definitely superior to men because you give them, like kafi purana tweet tha, you give them vegetable, they'll give you food. You give them a sperm, they'll give you life.
And you also feel their shit, she will.
But something in it, is something that I want to know. And then when you pick up the subject, I know pick up subjects made is work as a call. Identity attached. Even I think in when they talk for 12 today, he felt attached to the store, and even now he say it as
to show it to the world.
Yeah.
But were you not a little hesitant with the whole fact that this is the most politically controversial film you're doing?
Yep. No, you're absolutely right. I think I was not just nervous, I was scared. I was scared because unfortunately this tragedy has a political connotation attached.
Exactly.
But then somebody has to tell these stories. And to be honest, I consider myself very fortunate that people want me or probably associate, you know, strong content or, you know, for the lack of a better word, different content in cinema with me. I'm glad Ekta reached out to me with this. I was apprehensive, but then, you know, deep down inside, when I read the script and when I did my fair bit of research, a lot of it which was provided already, I felt that, you know, as I said, somebody has to tell these stories, so why not
Absolutely.
Me?
And I feel this cast that I see today of three of you is the best cast that could have happened for Sabarmati Airport.
Thank you so much.
Because in a way, the audience needs to be in that very zone itself.
We expect
different films from you. We expect films which create a stir in the society. And I think this is going to make a conversation.
I hope.
Absolutely. Yeah. But there was one thing that came across very starkly in the trailer launch as well. And it was the fact that this is an incident which is not being... which is not there outside anywhere. But this was thoroughly researched.
Yeah.
So will we also, as audience, I'm very curious to know, will we also, because I don't belong to that period of time.
Yep.
So I am that generation who doesn't know about it the way how, you know, I will be seeing it or watching it. So will we be also getting a glimpse of all the research that has gone into it? And when you were a part of this research or production, or even when you were shooting it, what was that one thing that you have taken away from the film that you will always keep with yourself? It's too invite.
I think for me, I would say what audiences that have probably never seen, you know, they've not known of this history that we've had. I think what they should take away from this is to, because you live in a world now, the younger generation is in a world of excess of information.
Exactly.
So I hope the one thing that you take away from this,
and
it should blow your mind, is that if we do not believe everything we see on television or we see in news, we should check it and we should use our own thinking brain and thinking mind to understand what all goes on behind those cameras to tell us what they're trying to tell us is the truth.
Exactly.
You know? So as a layman, I think that's the one thing I would say that one should take away from this.
With that.
On similar lines, actually, you know, such a major event or such a major pivot point in our modern political history or social history.
Absolutely.
And not spoken about at all. I mean, our collective ignorance.
Yeah.
There are so many things which probably could be happening right now, but not because we don't want to know, but because it's just not there for us to know, or we don't sort of focus enough or pay attention enough to things which could probably be such important pivot points for a society.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
But do you guys ever hesitate, you know, at the end of the day, you're humans and you've been giving interviews, especially for a controversial subject like this, day in and day out. It is possible to make mistakes. It is possible and it is okay to be opinionated as well and to stick by that opinion and to not have that kind of opinion being agreed upon. We are humans.
Yep.
So do you feel it's unfair that actors are told that if you're doing a film like Sabarmati Report, you also have to be very politically correct and politically moral? You cannot deflect from that. Do you feel it's unfair?
It is. I mean, not just with a particular film. I think with everything that we do, and I think I can speak for the entire community, there are so many eyes on us.
Mm-hmm.
There is very little benefit of doubt given to us,
Absolutely.
Considering the fact that we are humans ourselves.
Exactly.
And you can never go wrong. And these days, the actors also have to get their politics right, their GK right, their current affairs right, everything right besides acting.
Exactly.
So it's so much of pressure, you know. But that is how it is, and it's unfair.
Absolutely.
Yeah, it's absolutely unfair. I completely agree with him that, you know, just because we're actors, you know, at the end of the day, all we need to do is act. But he put it absolutely bang on.
Absolutely bang on, actually. And on that note, lastly, what was the inspiration for you while you were, you know, getting ready for these characters that you were embodying?
For the Sabarmati Report?
Yes.
I think for me it would be in a gist if I say the fact, I've been saying this in all interviews, you know, how there is the truth and there is the dancer perspective around the truth.
Yeah.
I just, as a common person from this country, want to reach out, because, you know, I know media, I work in media. Before I was an actor, I was also working in a channel. So I understand how media operates. And once you know something from the inside, it's not even easy for me to explain it to an outsider. But through this medium, I wish from the film I can tell, you know, every other citizen out there that I can't personally go and talk to, that open your eyes, you
exactly.
know, do not rely or trust everything that you see blindly. Do trust it and, you know, see where it's coming from, but do open your eyes and don't fight with each other, you know, keep a little humanity alive and don't be ignorant.
Very true.
Sorry, what was the first part of your question?
Whom do you draw inspiration from?
For this film?
Yes.
I think probably those people who were just mere statistics.
Yeah.
Mm.
Those 59 people who unfortunately had no idea what was awaiting them. So I did this story for them.
Wow.
I did this film for them.
Wow. Yeah. Super. And I think we don't need any more questions after that statement. And I hope you guys find the truth out in 15 November in theatres near you. Please don't forget to watch Sabarmati Report. It's a very, very beautiful film and it's a very important film. And I hope you discuss it as well after
yes.
watching.
Yes, please do.
And
please
that
do.
Was me, Manjari Mukherjee, only on Pop Diaries channel. Like, share, subscribe, don't forget to click on the bell icon.
Definitely.
Don't forget to comment. And until next time.